Okay, so while we're running for the meeting, tutorials, all sorts, and if anybody wants a tutorial on something, I can make a little video and I can put it up there. And then the Healthy You Festival video will be going up there. I did a video in the snow for the Healthy You Festival, but now they've done my bit, so I can now put it on our YouTube channel. So nice and tall, sink the hips. Open. watch out for your friends. No fighting. So you're all right, Wansu, if you haven't got anyone to whack with your arms.
Where's the lamp shelf?
This room, when I first started teaching here, I thought this room was massive. Now, so yeah, if you enjoy this and nice and relaxed and fancy an extra class, I do a class on Monday mornings at 10:30. I will bring a poster. It's on the poster. I'll bring some little. I'll get the guys at Histon. They're really good at making flyers and things, and I might do some A5 little flyers called Tai Chi and Tea. So we do what we do in this class. This is a Chen style class. And then at half time we stop for tea, coffee, hot chocolate and biscuits. And then we carry on for a little bit more after the tea break. And then it's very civilised, Tai Chi and tea. We get chairs out and sit and have a chat. So if you fancy
relaxing.
Yeah, it's like Tai Chi at high tea. I've done that at the or chai tea. Chai tea, Tai Chi. We should do chai tea for Tai Chi, shouldn't we? I'll try and get some. But, and then shake. Say, so just shake. Like you're, I was at Wickham Fen the other day, and then this Labrador emerged from the water. And then the owner was very happy, and the dog was very happy, and it went all over me, and it had pond weed over top. And then it bounced over to me, having sprayed it, and went boing, boing, boing. Oh, hello. Yeah. Oh, he's very friendly, yes. This is horrible. So imagine you're a very happy dog, and you've just emerged out of your favourite watery place, and you're just very, and everyone, you're really happy to see everyone, and you want to spray them with the pond. There you go, have some dog water. Be nice. And then, there we are. We just, So you use your whole body to bounce, and you're connecting through the, now let's do these. So that's my friend Nick, you can hear, playing his harp. So me, Nick and Eleanor, last year, we did this winter thing at the Haddenham Arts Centre. And we basically played chilled out music all day. So we got teas, coffee, soups, rolls, bread rolls and things. And we had a hat out. We didn't do very well because people were so relaxed and they were all staring this lovely art. But they're going to pay us next time because we did such a good job. So. Oh, it's fabulous. Yeah, but the Swaffham Fire at 10:30 in the morning, or the 5:30 one, if anyone wants to do punches. We've just started doing punching and hitting pads for not aerobic. Very, very gentle. So we're learning how to hold the pads, and we're learning how to do things. So I'm just, because we're sort of starting from the beginning, really.
What time is that on? 5:30 on a Monday.
Yeah, at Swaffham.
It's good
for aerobic, because I'm doing a lot of very relaxing stuff. But so that means my Monday class and my Friday morning class, I do more on Zoom. I do some more aerobic. Okay. names, what the cat's doing and why, and how not to annoy them, and things like that. Very, very good, very informative, because I do a bit of cat sitting periodically.
Right.
Yeah. So I get to stay in his big posh house with his cat.
Oh,
fantastic. Oh, it's brilliant. So this is called Bird Folds Its Wings. It's nothing to do with cats. And we come around, see, like that. So, especially in cold weather, you want to be kind to your body and just ease yourself into the exercise rather than forcing, well, we must do this. And then one more time. There we go. That's it. Fantastic. So, check your posture, see the hips back and down. And then the head's floating. As the hips sink, feel the contact with your feet on the ground. Breathing out. Okay, let's do Peng waves its wings. So the Peng is a big mythological bird, and one wing covers half of the earth. That's how big we are. So we're going to turn the palm, so you rotate in the shoulder joint, you turn the waist, you raise, you rotate, you turn down. Just so Nick said it was all right for me to use his music if I'm doing like a relaxation class. So palm up, rotate. Okay, let's do a few the other side. So posture check first. Turn the hand and then up we go. So yeah, it's not the punching thing on a Monday. It's not at any high or fast level. We're just looking at real nuts and bolts and technique. Yeah, because holding the pads is quite tricky, isn't it?
Yeah. You haven't done it before, you don't know what you're doing.
You don't know what you're doing, and that's why we're really taking all the time we need in order to do the... So we're not even really set up for doing the moves yet, but we're just taking our time, and then eventually we'll get there.
Okay. Well, it's warm, though. It's warm.
It does. Nice and relaxed. Shake the shoulders. Okay, and then just shake the legs. Start with the legs. So this is a good one that I get out every now and then for when it's cold weather. So it's one I learned from Erica Scuba, so she's in Reading. So I'll need to give her a bell later. I want to find out if they're teaching anything useful this weekend. Okay, and then the hips. Get your hips going. This is like the Rakshaki doll. I love that. Wonderful, but
yeah.
With the tassels. Brilliant. And they have these things on the hips and you can see them swinging around. Fantastic. Okay, and then the tummy. Well, this is good for, you know, their mince,
everything.
Not mince pudding, mince pies,
and biscuits.
Christmas pie.
Yeah.
And then chest. Okay, shoulders. There we go. Right, so that's another one for Megan. Okay, so let's do hands on the hips, circling. One, two, three, four. Yeah, but the problem is, and we'll do five in the other direction, we'll come back to that one. The problem in cold weather, it makes your lower back a bit stiff, so that's why we're just taking it, we're easing ourselves in. Okay, so we'll just focus on the lower back for the next couple of movements, and then we'll, so what we do now is you just very gently stretch the hand up.
No.
Yeah, we did. You blinked, didn't you? You blinked. And then turn the palm over. Now you can have the hand pointing at you. You don't have to make a fist if you don't want to. That's more of a stretch without the fist, actually. So we'll do a stretchier version. One down, one up. Yeah, we'll keep it unfisted. Turn, 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 turn. Stretch down. So you should feel a stretch on the side. And we're taking our time, that's it. Imagine you're getting a bit bigger. So see if you can get more room between your foot and your hands. That's it. Yeah. Well, you wouldn't have been able to do that a while back, would you? Good job. Yeah. It's definitely got better, hasn't it?
Yeah. Thanks.
Well, and the physio will come up. A lot of physio. One more time, but yeah, Tai Chi does help. Oh, it's good, isn't it? So it helps ease out your lower back. Helps ease out your lower back. And then we come back. That's getting a bit better, isn't it? Okay, now what we're going to do is we're going to do the Monkey King takes a seat. Now this one, you've got to be very mindful of the alignment between the knees and the toes. That your knees are in line with the toes and not kind of going inwards or outwards. I'll just show you that from the front and I'll show from the side. So I sink my hips back, my hands counterbalance, and as you can see, my knees are in line with the toes, and then I come back up again, nice and tall. From the side, it looks like this. And then we come back, and we're lengthening through the spine. We're going to do that. Let's do six. Here we go. One. Come back nice and slow. Then you come upright, sink hips. Nice. Two. Almost hip width, but the hands are going outwards. clapping. Have a little shake out first, and then I'll just demonstrate. So we're going to go eight of those, and then eight of those, and then we kick back the calf with the back of the foot. Tap the foot on the floor, and that will work just as well. So swap it for something that's not going to make you lose balance. Right. So we just get our posture just so. And then when we bend, we're sinking these hips back for that. And notice my back is straight. I'm not arching. Okay, inside. One, two. Good. Softly for five, six, seven, and eight. On the top, 2, 3, 4, 5, start the hammer. So we say, and on the side, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and on the back, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8, and then we come upright. Now you can either toe tap, or you can kick the back of your heel. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, we use a wall. Doing that. So each finger moves individually, da, 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 like that.
How are we doing? Rolling back.
Oh, you'll have to catch up. Catch up. Watch it on YouTube. I'll try and get it saved in the right format. 7, 8. Well done. And then over and under. Thanks for making the effort to come. 2, 3, 4, 5. There's more room there. 6, 7, 8. Then 10 of these. 1, 2, and the bounce. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. now. So I'm using my left, you can use your right. If you're facing this way, just wing it. So it goes down, in. Now, Grandmaster Chen Xiaowang, there's a video of him doing this exercise on YouTube, and it's over at about, it's about an hour and a half, and he just does this move over and over and over again. So I watched it for a bit, and then I went, okay, what's he doing? Oh, he's still doing the same thing. Okay. That's it.
So we don't have to.
So we don't have to, but it's very good to do these movements over and over again, because then you feel it, and it gets kind of ingrained in the body. Sleepy tiger, sleepy. So it's not missing anything, but it looks very relaxed. But...
I'm doing the dozy side.
Yeah.
Can I just confirm where the knees are meant to be?
The knees there, the knees are in line with the toes. The
knees are in line with the stretching over.
Yeah, that's right.
Okay,
so
that's
what happens
know, yeah.
is there's a rotation outwards in the hip joint. Or you can think of just the knee as pointing where the toes. As a rule of thumb, the knees always point where the toes point.
Right.
Because you want the knee muscles inside of the knee to be used equally.
Yes, because they hurt. So I'm aware my knees are doing that.
Yeah, you wanna just transfer the weight, and then when you turn, this comes out. And maybe bend a little less at the beginning while you're getting your leg straight up. So it's like this. So you turn, you transfer, you turn. Now, when you turn, watch this back knee here, that it doesn't cave in. You want to... So, is it aching pain or a sharp pain?
Yeah, just a... No, not sharp pain.
Stop. If it's an aching pain, that means just you're...
I'm working something.
You're working something,
yes.
Yeah.
Twisting something in the
yeah, exactly.
That's
yeah.
what I'm getting at. Yeah.
But if you're getting a working pain...
We're holding hands.
So, eventually there isn't one, but it's a bit like if you go to the gym for the first time. It's
yeah.
a bit... You'll notice,
yeah.
you'll think, you wake up the next day and go,
Oh, stiff last week when we went around your shoulders and
yeah.
like that here. Oh, it's done me good. It
yeah.
didn't last long.
So, relax the arm more. Okay, the arm's floating. Everyone to relax the arm more. So it comes out, now it comes down. So the little fingers pointing, like you've got a little blade. And you're cutting down. Then it scoops under. Okay, let's do the other side. So we'll just start here like this. So I either rest my hand here or rest my hand there. So I can monitor the opening and closing of the hip, or I can monitor the turning of the waist. So it comes in at the bottom, then you turn, it comes out at the top, and watch the alignment of the knees. Sink the hips. So you sink the hips and that puts your knees in line as well. So what you want to do is you want to stay down. So in at the bottom, up, out at the top, out at the top, out from the middle at the top, out from the middle at the top. It's that way. So watch. This is my middle, this is the end. You're going from the middle to the end. Middle. Out, down, into the middle, down, into the middle, turn, out, that's in, you're going out, you're going out, that's it, that's out, then you go down, down, in, so point with your finger, in, point with your elbow, out, down. Point with your finger, in. Point with your elbow, out. There you go. Yeah, perfect. You meant that all along, didn't you? Very good. So it's about... There's a few things going on. You want to pay attention with what you are doing, and you want to match what you're doing with what's being demonstrated. So you want to, because sometimes you'll see what's happening and then you'll do it, but then when you examine what you're doing, you're not doing it, you're doing something else. So it's about realising that that's happening. And it's, yeah, you know, it's what happens. You can be completely convinced that what you're doing is exactly what's being demonstrated, and pretty much nobody's doing.
You need a stick.
No one's doing
it. Stick, yeah.
Not really. No, you just need to notice what you're doing. Notice. So in Tai Chi, you're paying attention to what you're feeling, what you're doing, what you can feel, what you can sense. So you're using all your senses, your eyes, nose, ears, proprioception, kinesthetic awareness, whatever. And then you're also noticing your environment. So Tai Chi is brilliant for things like stewarding, because I'm one of the stewards. I was a steward for the council, and then I only do Ely Folk Festival and Cambridge Folk Festival stewarding. But you start walking around and you notice, oh, there's some litter over there. Oh, that child's fallen over, I'll take it to first aid. You know, that person's smoking, I'll turn them off. You know, and you notice things. And it's about noticing what's happening in the environment and noticing what you're doing. So the second way, silk reeling number two, have a look. So just watch. So demonstration, observe. So you come across, and then you come down. Take your time, you come across, and you come up. So this is the second of the silk reeling. I'll show you that from the other side. So it comes. So the arms float. So this time you come in at the top and out at the bottom. That's how you can tell you've changed direction. So there's some very complicated silk. So in the Tai Chi and tea class, we can get a lot more covered with a tea break because it's an hour and a half. So if you fancy coming along to that, it's not good. It's a very small select group at the moment. I'm still keeping it going because basically my other classes are kind of supplementing my less lower attended classes. But it would be nice to get the attendance up. So when you're presented with something novel, relax more, make it your default. And then no matter how complicated it is, so then that scoops in. Oh, I love this one. This is one of the ones we did at Haddenham. A lot of the music that he's playing on this, we all played together as a trio at Haddenham. The artist did brilliant that day. So now we change directions. There we go. So you can do things like this. by relaxing, you'll be able to see them. Let's just for fun, my fun, let's give that a go. I'll show from the front and then I'll turn round. So have your right hand on top, left hand underneath. Go towards your left, go towards your right, go towards your left. Open, keep this other hand going, keep the other hand going, and then you go, whoosh, lovely. And then you come in and just relax more. Just relax and enjoy the confusion. Yeah, so yeah, I was at a concert last night and we were collecting money for some Iranian charities, and the lady sung a song at the end. It was in Iranian. She basically wanted us to learn the words, and I said it's okay. I could hum the tune, but no, you wouldn't want to. If my family hear me try and speak Dari at them, they just laugh at me and say I sound in English. So don't worry about it, just join in as best you can and just enjoy not being able to, you know, just relax, just do something, just do a thing. Just float, yeah, that's it. Busk it. There we are, look, you're perfect, look, you're all brilliant. Now I could turn the camera around and show at the amazing variations. This is like Tai Chi jazz right now. There we are.
Do you think we're signing that?
Yeah, it's good. Next. Let's try this one. So you turn, you open, you come back to the middle. You turn, you open. See, that's so much easier now, isn't it? This is very, very good for your brain function, this movement. So even if you're doing a variation, it's okay. The fact that you're moving both sides of your body means you're exercising your brain with whatever it is you're doing. Fantastic. Here we are. Fantastic, look at that. Oh, brilliant. Okay, let's do this one. So this is one I learnt from Evica Scuba. 4, 5. So you're rocking the weight from one foot to the other. It's nice and relaxed. And then you do that the other side. So you put it forward, you sink back, open. This is a nice one for the shoulders. And it's nice, isn't it?
Yeah, really, a nice massage.
Nice massage for the shoulders. So in the form, slightly different. So in the form, you go like that, and then it comes down, and then you come up into that position. We'll do the form at some point. Okay, just for the last 5 or 10 minutes, let's whiz through the Fasungong, first 8 of the Fasungong. So what we're doing, we're doing balancing the yin and yang, so we just transfer the weight. We're breathing. Oh. It warmed up really well in this room, didn't it? I think all the concentration has caused all the brains to overheat and maybe heated the room up. So. And then we raise the heel. Balancing yin and yang. And then back to the middle, you come up, out, down, in. And then the way down. Move your way down and raise the hip. Raise the hip. Raise the hip. Raise the hip. Yeah. Okay, we better move on. Circling the wrist. Now, this is another one of those movements that have got a lot of variation. Don't worry, just relax the arms. Keep this alive feeling right to the end of the fingers, right to the end of the fingers. That's it, we're breathing. And we transfer the weight. We transfer the weight. Fantastic. Oh. Amazing wings as she was singing. Yes, but this movement. Now, if you had a pair of fairy wings, you could bring them round and then swoosh round. And this, yeah, that's it. So, I wanted to actually say, no, this is how you do your wings. Just, and then raise the heel. Raise the hip. Yeah. Raise the hip. So think about swooshing your wings around. So, well, like a big cloak, you know, like a kind of pantomime villain type. If that helps. Fantastic. That's great. And then the eighth movement is my favourite movement, because I love the name. It's called Ape Offers Fruit. So it's probably quinces, isn't it? So we go. Like that. So like that. And you rotate the shoulders and come palm down and around. This is number one. This is wonderful for the shoulders. Wonderful for the shoulders. Come forward and down. Forward and down. And then we do a weight transfer and then we've got the choir is about to arrive. We'll have to stop soon. I was just getting into it. See, that's the other advantage of my Tai Chi tea on a Monday morning. We get a whole quarter of an hour, 20 minutes, depending on how long our tea break is.
Depending on how big your biscuits are.
Yeah. exercises?
Sure.
Great. And then this is the final move. So just breathe in. Breathe out. So regulating the breathing, calming the mind. Yeah, my boss at the Haddon Arts Centre, she was like, oh, so nice. Yeah, they were really relaxed in the cafe, they were really chilled. Okay, embrace the tiger return to the hat, that's great. So we've only got three more moves with that set, and then we've got the whole set. So I'll try and fit them in next week. And, yeah, do tell your friends about these classes, or make some and tell them, and then see how many potholes come as a result. Reach now part of the. Yeah, it really confused. I was like, why are all these cars doing here? And then they said, oh, it's because they've shut the road. That wasn't very sensible. Okay, now rub the hands together. So I put my glasses there. Rub the hands together and polishing the face. We punish the face. Lovely. And then rub the hands together again.
And give your lower back a rub, and you've got your back as well.
Oh, that's lovely, that bit, isn't it? It's brilliant. Okay, and then we'll embrace the tiger, return to the mountain again to finish off. So just check your posture. Let's just go back to that one. See how it feels now. You should hopefully your back. It's amazing, isn't it? It's like the backs have melted a bit, haven't they? It's great. Bit of oil, yeah, a bit of WD.
Yeah.
WD-40. Cosmic WD-40, I think. Good. Okay, so here we go. We'll see if we'd better finish, because the problem is with the door shut, if one of the choir comes in, then they all look really embarrassed when they come. We don't want to do that to them. It's embarrassing. And then one more time. Oh. And just stand for a moment. Really own your space. Tall. Relax around the jaw. And then make a fist with right hand, left hand over the top. Bring your feet together. And back. Ooh, well done. See, I wasn't here on my own, those of you on Zoom. Really good.
Now come and say, hang on, I'll start recording.